So let's have a look at the drop jump here, an example of a drop jump. So starting on a fairly low box, so we're talking about 30 centimeters, and we're jumping to a bit of a higher box, I think 90 centimeters. Okay, now, so let's look at this in slow motion. Yeah, so first thing here, the name drop jump indicates that it's a drop jump. So you can see here she's not dropping down, she's jumping down. So you can also see here the distance between where she lands and where the box is. So ideally you would want to have the box, this box, much closer to this box. So that's the first thing. So instead of dropping down, as jumping down, which will lead to much more, to a much bit of a bigger dip here, and also increases contact time on the ground. So that's not what we want. Ideally, the drop jump teaches the short stretch shortening cycle and should be as quick off the ground as possible, so really short contact. So by jumping down, that increases, see, dropping down, that increases the contact time. It's not ideal. So first thing here, get the box closer to it and then drop down rather than jumping down. So, but then that is fine, it's a good extension. But then the landing position, that's not ideal. So the hip is pretty low and the head is between the knees. So you would much rather see more of a kind of ideally this position as well on the landing. So a much higher landing. So the solution here would be choosing a lower box that allows you to land in this position. I know it's very, very difficult to get it into the head of athletes. That's what you can see in this example here, because they always want to challenge themselves to jump to higher boxes. But if the end result is this, then, yeah, what to say. So I much rather have jumping to lower boxes, so not holding back on the effort of jumping up. So it should definitely be a maximum effort of jumping up, but the landing position should be looking more like this rather than this. And you can also see the right foot from here, the foot in the back, that's not even fully on the box. So a few things that could be improved in this exercise, starting with first point, getting the box closer, the box where the athlete drops off, much closer to the box where the athlete ultimately lands. Then also dropping off the box rather than jumping off the box. Actually, this one, the eccentric phase, the amortization and the concentric phase, that looks pretty good. I mean, she's absorbing the forces very well and then recoiling into the concentric movement, that's fine. But then again, the landing position, choosing a lower box and being able to land in a much more upright position, kind of the athletic basic position.